Hello students of class 12th, I welcome you in today's English literature lecture. Today I am going to start a new poem, The True Beauty, written by Thomas Carey. Now, about the poet. Thomas Carey was the favorite poet of King Charles I of England. He belonged to the group of writers known as the Cavalier Poets. He is known for his lyrics. His poems are easy and graceful. His favorite theme is love and honor. His poems are highly musical. He is very fond of similes and metaphors. About the poem. The poem, The True Beauty, is composed by Thomas Carey, who won the favor of King Charles I of England. The poem is a lyric. It is one of his most famous poems. The poet points out that the essential things for true beauty are gentle thoughts, calm desires, and firm-mindedness. The poem inculcates in us a genuine regard for spiritual beauty and teaches us the lesson that we should not be after appearances as physical charms decay with the passage of time. So now I shall start the poem. First stanza. He that loves a rosy cheek or a coral lip admires, or from star-like eyes doth seek fuel to maintain his fires. As old time makes these decay, so his flames must waste away. अब देखिए बच्चों, इस लाइन इस स्टैंजा में जो कवि हैं थॉमस कैरी, वो क्या कह रहे हैं? वो ये कहते हैं कि जो व्यक्ति यानी यहाँ पर प्रेमी से संबंधित है, जो प्रेम करने वाला व्यक्ति है, अपनी प्रेयसी के गुलाबी कपोलों को प्रेम करता है, अथवा मूंगे जैसे लाल होंठों की प्रशंसा करता है, तथा सितारों जैसी चमकदार आँखों में अपने प्रेम की अग्नि को प्रज्वलित रखने के लिए ईंधन की तलाश करता है। उसकी प्रेम अग्नि अवश्य ही समाप्त हो जाएगी, क्योंकि समय की गति यानी वृद्धावस्था के साथ शारीरिक सुंदरता जैसे गुलाबी काल, लाल होंठ तथा सुंदर आंखें भी नष्ट हो जाती हैं। सो द पोएट हैज ट्राइड टू एक्सप्लेन इन दीज लाइन्स दैट इफ समबडी लव्स समवन, we should love not from mind but from heart. That too, we should not love the rosy cheeks, the coral lips, the red coral lips, or star-like eyes, because these things maintain the fire of love. But as time passes on, these things get decayed. So if love is made by heart, then that love is the pure love, and that love is the true love, and it will remain forever and ever, because the heart never decays. Second stanza. But a smooth and steadfast mind, gentle thoughts and calm desires, hearts with equal love combine, kindly never dying fires, where these are not I despise, lovely cheeks or lips or eyes. लेकिन एक सा रहने वाला तथा दृढ़ मस्तिष्क, सुंदर विचार तथा शांत इच्छाएं और समान प्रेम से जुड़े हृदय चिरस्थाई प्रेमाग्नि को प्रज्वलित रखते हैं, जहाँ पर ये वस्तुएं नहीं होती, वहाँ मैं सुंदर गालों, ओंठों अथवा आँखों से घृणा करता हूँ। सो इन दिस लाइन्स द पोएट सेज दैट वेयर देयर इज अ स्टेडफास्ट माइंड, दैट इज अ डिसिप्लिन्ड माइंड, अ काम एंड डिसिप्लिन्ड माइंड, gentle thoughts and calm desires, where desires are there but the desires are very calm and quiet and the thoughts are very gentle, that is we respect the other person also through our heart, hearts with equal love combined, where the love is being shared from both the sides by heart, there only the kindly never dying fires, there the love, the fire of love never dies, it always continues to burn and burn, where these are not I despise lovely cheeks or lips or eye, and if the love between two hearts is not present then the writer says that true love cannot be seen for a long time because as the time passes, the lovely cheeks, the lips and the eyes get decayed due to old age and then there will be no space for love left to love further because these were the fireworks of the love made by seeing coral lips, eyes and cheeks. And if we are loving someone through heart, the heart will never decay till the last breath of life. So if we want to love somebody, we should love through our hearts and not with our minds. I think children, you must be able to understand both the stanzas. Now, the appreciation of the poem. The poet has pointed out that the essential things for true beauty or gentle thoughts, calm desires and firm-mindedness. Physical beauty decays with the passage of time. The love based on nobility of character remains permanent. The simile used in the phrase star-like eyes is very remarkable as it highlights the attractive power of the beloved's eyes. The metaphors used in fuel and fire are very telling and powerful and heighten the poetic effect of the poem. Now this is the glossary part of this poem. Coral lip, a lip which is as red as the gem called coral. Star-like eyes, eyes which are as bright, deep and romantic as the stars in the sky. Fuel to maintain his fire. For most people, physical charms such as rosy cheeks, coral lips and star-like eyes are the basic requirements for the sustenance of their love. These physical attractions supply as it were fuel to the fires of their love which is very likely to die out in the absence of the former. Flames, intensity of love in the heart of the lover, waste away, dwindle in health and vitality. A smooth and steadfast mind, a mind which is not feeble but is rather constant and stable. Hearts with equal love combined. Women who have gentle thoughts and calm desires combined with love in the same degree. Kindly never dying fires. The love generated by virtuous minds and loving hearts is everlasting. Now, you have to write, children, the reference, context and explanation of these two stanzas. The first one is, he that loves to waste away, and the second one is, but a smooth dash lips or eyes. So here I have completed a poem, The True Beauty, written by Thomas Carew. Now it's your duty to write the central idea of the poem as well as the reference, context and explanation of these two stanzas. So for today, this much only. I'll come with another lesson in the next lecture. So thank you, children.